Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
Whether you're new to the iPhone or you just need a refresher, learning how to navigate iOS is a great place to start. In this video, I'm going to show you some of the basics, including how to operate your device using multi-touch gestures. Let's begin with the home screen, which is the screen you see here. It includes shortcuts to all of your apps and several different screens to help you stay organized. You can navigate between them using the swipe gesture. There's also the dock at the bottom and the status bar at the top. Here you can swipe down to view your notifications. Notifications can alert you to many different things on your device, including new messages, emails, reminders, and more. To open a notification, tap the one you want. You'll be taken straight to the source, in this case, the calendar app. From here, it's easy to return home using the Home button on the outside of your device. Keep this button in mind because you're going to use it pretty frequently. After all, the home screen is sort of like the desktop on your home computer. To open any app, all you have to do is tap the icon. Why don't we try Maps? Sometimes it can be difficult to see the screen on your device because it is fairly small. Luckily, there are two different ways to zoom in and out. For example, in some apps, all you have to do is double tap, and the app will adjust automatically. In other apps, you may find it easier to use the pinch gesture. Let's go back to the home screen. There are certain settings that you might want easy access to while using your device, for example, Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. You'll find these things in the Control Center. Just swipe up from the bottom of the home screen. Here you can adjust your screen brightness, turn on airplane mode, and even set your device to Do Not Disturb. This will temporarily silence any calls or alerts you receive. To close the Control Center, swipe down again. The last thing I'd like to show you is how to use the search feature. This feature is great for finding apps, media, and other items on your device that you're having trouble locating. All you have to do is swipe down anywhere in the middle of the home screen. Now type what you're looking for using the on-screen keyboard. The keyboard appears anytime you're in a text field. It's even sensitive to what you might be typing, and sometimes offers shortcuts. For example, a key that inserts .com if you're typing a web address. To navigate to the item you're looking for, tap it on the list. That covers the basics of iOS for the iPhone. Now that you know your way around, you can start using your device and taking advantage of everything it has to offer.